in every department, in every faculty. Yes, O Lord, you alone deserves the glory. Holy, holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Lift up those hands and tell, worthy is the Lamb. Just tell him, tell him.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Sing holy.
You are holy.
Come on, do it with meaning.
Holy.
Father, we say you are Lord God Almighty.
I am Lord God Almighty.
Confess to him, holy.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Tell him you're holy.
You are holy.
Holy. Amen.
Amen.
Now let me ask you to lift up those hands and we say hallelujah together. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We join the angels and the archangels.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Lord God Almighty reigns.
Come on, sing it if you mean it. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns.
In your own voice, let us sing it together.
Hallelujah.
Holy.
Holy.
Holy. You are my Mukama.
Holy.
You are Lord God Almighty.
Are you Lord God Almighty?
Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Hallelujah.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Hallelujah. You are holy.
Holy.
Hallelujah.
Holy.
Are you Lord God Almighty?
Are you Lord God Almighty?
Yeah.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Lord God Almighty.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Amen.
Amen.
Up your voice and let's exalt the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Come on, just lift your voice and let's exalt the King of Kings. You are Alpha and Omega. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Come on, just lift up your hands and raise your voice and let's exalt his greatness. There is none like you indeed. We say holy, holy, holy. Lord, we join the heavenly hosts and declare your greatness, O God. We join the heavenly hosts and say, Hosanna to the Lamb of God. Hosanna to the one who was before the world was. Hosanna to the great I am. You are the Alpha and Omega. Be magnified, Abba Father. Be lifted on high, O God. We lift you on high, King Jesus. We adore you this moment, O God. Receive the glory, receive the honor, Lord. Lord, it's all about you. We come this moment because we want to lift you on high. Yes, Lord. We come back to a place of worship. We come back to a place of adoration. We come back to a place of exaltation. We come back to the place where we lie. We lay prostrate before you, O God, and join the heavenly host and say, holy, 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 holy are you, O God. The heavens declare your greatness. Hosanna to the Lamb of God. You are worthy, O God. You are worthy to be magnified. You are worthy to be lifted up. You are worthy. You are worthy, O God. Who is there like you? Who compares to you? Yes, Lord. We bow before you to worship you, O God. We bow your throne of grace and lift you on high. We bow before you and say, you are the Alpha and Omega. You are the reason for our existence. We live in you and move, O God. We can breathe because you are in us, O God. You are lifted, O God. Be magnified, O God. Be exalted, O God. Yes, who is there like you? None compares to you. Hallelujah. We bless your name this moment, King Jesus. You are Alpha and Omega. Yes, Lord. Take your place, O God. Take your place in our midst this afternoon. Take your place in our hearts, O God. Come on, allow him to have his way. Let the King of Glory come in and let all the ancient doors fall open right now, and let all the raised doors and all the raised walls bow down to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, because he is here. Yes, you are here, O God. We adore you. Oh, we lift you on high, and that's why we say, be magnified, O God. Be magnified this afternoon. Be magnified, our friend. Be magnified, our friend. Yes, you are. Yes, you are the beginning and the end. You are worthy, O God. Who compares to you, our Lord? Who compares to you, King of Kings? Who is like you, O God? Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Your presence is heaven to us. Your presence. Come on, welcome his presence as we sing that song. Choir, we can continue as we welcome him. Yes, my brother and sister, welcome the King of Kings, because he is in our midst. Your presence, we welcome you, Lord. Move in this place, oh God. Move in our hearts this moment, oh God. Move in this place, oh God. I will long to see you this afternoon, oh God. Take center stage, oh God, as we worship you. We come because we are desperate for you. We come because we want to see you, oh God. We come because we want to connect with you, oh God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We welcome you, Jesus. We welcome you, Jesus. We welcome you, our friend. We welcome you. Come on, just release yourself in the presence of the Lord. Just release yourself in the presence of the Lord. Just release yourself even as we do the first verse of that song. Who is there like you, oh God? Just release yourself, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Just release yourself. Just release yourself, Lord. Just release yourself and let the Lord take his stage. Let the Lord be exalted. It's not about us. It is not about us.
He's heaven to me.
Your presence.
All we want is you, Jesus.
Your presence.
All we want is you, Jesus.
Is heaven.
All we want is you, Abba Father.
Me.
Just take your place, oh God. Just have your way in us, oh God. Yes, Lord.
Your presence is heaven.
surrender all to you. Everything I give. As we sing that song, please just surrender to the Lord. Just release yourself. Just release yourself. You might be anxious about something. You might be so worried about that burden that you have in your heart. But be reminded that you're before the King of Kings. You're before the Lord of Lords. You're before the Alpha and Omega. And in the presence of the Lord, every burden melts away like wax. In the presence of the Lord, every burden melts away. Yes, Lord. Come on, surrender. Everything, Lord.
Everything
we surrender completely to you, oh God. We surrender this semester to you, oh God. We surrender every student to you. We surrender every lecturer. We surrender every leader. We surrender every office. We surrender every department. We surrender everything to you, oh God. We surrender to you, Lord. Come on, Lord. Lord, we choose to disappear, let it may appear. Lord, we surrender Uganda Christian University to you. We surrender Uganda Christian University to you. We surrender this university to you. Lord, the center of excellence in the heart of Africa. Lord, we cry to you that it will be the center of your presence. It will be the center of your presence, O God. Lord, have your way. We surrender all to you, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Withholding.
Lord, we choose to withhold nothing completely, oh God.
Withholding nothing.
Yeah, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Withholding nothing.
We give ourselves completely to you. Lord, my friends, just go ahead and talk to the Lord and surrender. Give your education to the Lord. Give your time here to the Lord. Give this season of your life to the Lord. Give this institution to the Lord. Lord, it's yours. Lord, we surrender to you. We surrender completely to you. Yes. It's not about us, oh God, but it's about you, Jesus.
I give myself away.
My God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We only say, have your way, Jesus. Have your way, Abba Father. Have your way. It is never about us. It is not about the chaplaincy, no, Lord. It is not about the vice chancellor, no, Lord. It is not about management, no. It is not about theology, no. It is not about the lecturers, no. It is not about the students. It is about you, Lord. Take the lead, Jesus. Take the lead. Take the lead. Take the lead.
Take the lead. So you can use me.
Thank you, Jesus. Friends, as we continue in that same mode of prayer, feel free to stand up, feel free to sit, feel free to kneel, because we came to pray this afternoon. And that's why we are calling upon you to release yourself in the presence of your Father. The theme that is guiding us this semester is faithful stewards of God's varied grace. Brothers and sisters, in 1 Peter chapter 4 and verse 10, the Lord speaks to us and he says, each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. Each and every one of us who is here, we are gifted. We are sent on earth for a mission. There is assignment upon your life and most so upon this great institution. We cannot become everything that God has called us to be unless we surrender. This semester, we are focusing on using our gifts to the glory of God. But we cannot use them unless we surrender to the Lord, unless we allow Him to have His way. So as we begin this semester, we want to start in the Lord and remain in the Lord. And for that reason, I'll take us to Romans 12 as we continue to pray. Romans 12 and verse 1, we are instructed. And so, dear brothers and sisters, I plead with you to give your bodies to God because of all He has done for you. Let them be a living and holy sacrifice, the kind He will find acceptable. This is truly the way to worship Him. As we worship this evening, this afternoon, as we connect, I want us to surrender to the Lord. We shall sing that hymn, I Surrender All to Him. And we shall, each and every one of us, give your life. Say, Lord, my life is not my own, but it's yours. And just ask the Lord to help each and every one of us, every student represented here, every faculty represented here, that this institution which belongs to the Lord, that we shall offer ourselves, that you and me, we shall offer ourselves to the Lord, that this institution shall be offered to the Lord, that every department shall be offered to the Lord, that every lecture you will have shall be offered to the Lord. Now let us lift up our voices as we sing that song. Please feel free. You don't have to get lost in the song. Connect with the Lord. Let the music go as you talk to the Lord. Yes, Lord.
I belong.
Thank you, Jesus.
I give myself to you.
Just give yourself to the Lord, as that scripture has instructed us.
My life is not my own.
We surrender completely to you.
To you I belong.
I give myself.
We shall sing softly as we allow our voices to come over the music. We shall sing softly, yes, as we lift up our voices to the Lord. Father, we thank you so much that this moment you're calling us to give ourselves to you as living sacrifices. Father, this moment, as your children called by your name, we gather because we know we cannot use our gifts without you taking the charge, without you taking the lead, without you consuming us. So this afternoon, we give ourselves completely to you. We surrender that our bodies will be living sacrifices to you, holy and acceptable unto you. Lord, we choose to die to the flesh. Come on, pray. You know your personal struggles. Come on, surrender them to the Lord, that we may die to the flesh, that you may die to those things that stand in the way, that God Himself will be evident in your life. Lord, we choose to die to the flesh. We choose to die to the pleasures of this world. We choose to die to the things of this world. We choose to surrender them to you. Lord, we are not worthy to be before you, but by the blood of Jesus, you qualify us and the curtain was torn, that we can be able to access the throne of grace. So in the blood of Jesus, we come before you, O God. Unworthy we might be, but we come to you this afternoon and surrender, and surrender. Lord, have your way. Move in our lives, O God. Lord, we give our hearts to you. Yes, Lord. May we be living sacrifices. We surrender ourselves on your altar, that you may destroy every kind of flesh in us. Yes, Lord.
To Jesus.
Yes, I surrender. But let's now surrender our institution. Lift up your voice. Surrender Uganda Christian University and all the different campuses and all the different campuses in the different locations. Lift your voice and surrender Uganda Christian University to the Lord. Surrender its mission. Yes, surrender its work to the Lord. Surrender all the activities that are set out to be done. Surrender the teaching, because that's the core of this university. Surrender. Surrender the different departments. Come on, lift up your voice and pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bring Uganda Christian University to you. This is your institution. This is your university. So we are crying to you this
this afternoon that Uganda Christian University may be indeed the center of your presence, may be indeed the place of prayer, and must say the place of academic excellence. So Lord, we surrender Uganda Christian University, that all our students, oh God, shall be men and women different from everyone in this world, oh God. That Lord, you will equip our lecturers, that you will work through management, that you will work through everyone. Yes, Lord. Uganda Christian University belongs to you, oh God.
Yes, Lord.
This university desires and believes that it is the center of excellence in the heart of Africa. God has set out this university to integrate faith in learning. God has set out this university to be the pinnacle of God's anointing and presence. God has sent out this university to be that light in the education sector in our nation, Uganda. God has set out this university to be the center of innovation.
Oh, yes.
God has set out this university to be the center of women and men of integrity that are going to transform our nation, Uganda. God has set out this university to be the source of all new great insights that come from the Lord. So let us pray. Come on, let us destroy the works of the enemy in this university. Every altar that has set itself up against the work of God in this university, let us destroy it in the name of Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, we don't wage war as the people of the world. No, our warfare is not against flesh and blood, but it's against principalities. It is against forces. It is against strongholds established in the heavenly realms. Yes. So now let us pray to pull down every thought. Let us pray according to 2 Corinthians chapter 10. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 3 says, For though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapon we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God. And we take captive every thought to make it obedient to Christ. And we will be ready to punish every act of disobedience once our obedience is complete. Let us pray, pulling down strongholds, pulling down evil forces, pulling down thoughts, pulling down arguments, pulling down traditions, pulling down perceptions that are not in line with the word of God, that are not in line with the mind of God, that are hindering the progress of this institution to becoming all that God has called it to be. Come on, lift up your voice. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for Uganda Christian University. You have set your university in place, that your purposes may prevail, that your will may prevail. So at this time, my Lord, we destroy every altar that has been established against your work here at Uganda Christian University. We destroy every sacrifice that was offered to destroy the work of God here. We nullify you in the name of Jesus. Every stronghold, every argument, every power in the heavenly realm, we pull you down in the name of Jesus Christ. Every evil force, every dark force, we destroy you. Every spirit of immorality, we destroy you. Every spirit of homosexuality, we destroy you. Every spirit of drunkenness, we destroy you. Every spirit of corruption, we destroy you. Every spirit of greed, we destroy you. All works of the enemy, we render them powerless in the name of Jesus. In the blood of Jesus. Yes, there is power. There is power in the blood of Jesus. Come on, let us plead the blood of Jesus. Let us declare the blood of Jesus over this great institution. Let us declare the blood of Jesus. Father, on that cross, The blood was shed to wash us as white as snow. Father, may your blood, may the blood of Jesus, may the blood of Jesus, the blood of your dear son, wash your children, cleanse this institution, cleanse our minds, cleanse your altars. Father, that the true altar shall be set to you alone. Father, reign in this university. We give it to you. This is your institution. Lord, let your will as it is in heaven be so concerning this university. Father, we thank you. Scripture tells us in Romans 12 and verse 2, do not copy the behavior and customs of this world, but let God transform you into new people by changing the way you think. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect. As we pray for this institution, we desire that God is purpose. We desire that God is will. We desire that God himself will come in all offices. He will guide management. He will guide our leaders. He will guide our lecturers. That indeed faith shall be integrated in service and learning. Come on, let us pray that the will of God concerning this institution, concerning every department, concerning management, concerning leadership will be so. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you because Jesus himself told his disciples that when we pray, we should ask that let your will as it is in heaven be so on earth. So we stand in the gap concerning Uganda Christian University and we pray, Lord, that your will as it is in heaven, your purpose, which is good, pleasing, and perfect, may be in place, O God. Lord, we pray that this institution, Heavenly Father, will be an institution with a distinction, will be an institution set apart for you. Father, we pray that this institution will be the center where people shall come and learn and glean wisdom. It will be a hub of innovation in the name of Jesus Christ. It will be a hub, yes, of great inventions in the name of Jesus. Lord, we commit, yes, the faculty of technology into your hands. We commit the faculty of technology into your hands. We pray for great insight. We pray that you alone, you will guide the head of department. That idea, that technological idea that you want to come through Uganda Christian University will be birthed. Because you've said you never cause one to go to labor and not bring to birth. So we pray that the ideas concerning technology shall be so in the name of Jesus. Now let us also pray, yes, for Bishop Tucker, yes, for the theology department, that indeed the true doctrine shall be proclaimed.
Yes.
That in that, yes, department, the school itself, that indeed the presence of God shall be evident in the instructions, yes, in the guidance, offering guidance not only to the university, but to the church at large and to the nation and the world at large. Indeed, may that prophetic voice, that prophetic message that was declared over Uganda come to pass, that indeed Uganda will be a sending nation, sending missionaries who have been groomed and trained. So let us pray for Bishop Tucker School of Theology. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you so much for Bishop Tucker School of Divinity and Theology. We bring it back to you. And on behalf of the school, we repent. We have not done your work as you've intended us to do it. We repent on behalf of that school in the name of Jesus Christ. So now we pray that indeed, as you've allowed us to be one, we pray that the true doctrine shall be proclaimed. We pray that indeed the word shall be taught without fear or favor. We pray that all ministers who are trained shall be trained in sound doctrine. And as they go out, they will go with power and authority, Lord, equipped by you, because scripture tells us all scripture is God breathed and it is given for rebuking, for teaching, for correcting, that every man of God will be thoroughly equipped. So we pray for thorough equipping in the name of Jesus. We pray for deep research in the name of Jesus, trying out areas that have not been tried out before, filling the gap those gaps, Lord. Show us, open our eyes to the true gaps in our world so that we can study and debate and engage in dialogical discussions so that everyone, oh God, your teaching shall come forth. So we pray that indeed it will lead us. This school will be used by you. We commit all the professors, all the lecturers, all the students, and we pray, dear Lord, that they will be exemplary. They will be exemplary in the light and the salt in Jesus' name. My dear friends, scripture tells us, verse 6 of Romans 12, in God's grace, he has given us different gifts for doing certain things well. So if God has given you the ability to prophesy, to speak out with as much faith as God has given you, if your gift is serving others, serve them well. If you are a teacher, teach well. If your gift is to encourage, encourage. If your gift is giving, give generously. If God has given you a new leadership ability, take responsibility seriously. And if you have a gift for showing kindness, now go ahead. So friends, let us pray that God will use the gifts that are on this campus. Gifts among our lecturers, among management, both non-teaching and teaching staff, and gifts within the students' community. Let us pray that these gifts God has given in our community, both natural and spiritual gifts, shall be evident, and they shall be nurtured in this community. They shall be fanned into flames. Let us pray. Some of us here don't even know our gifts. Pray that God will reveal to you your gift. Pray that we shall all come together. We are many, but we are one. Just like our bodies, different parts, but one body. So we need each other, that the leaders will do their part. Come on, pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you because we are all gifted by one God, one Spirit. Lord, each and every one of us is gifted in a number of ways. So we pray that you'll open our eyes to the gifts you've given to us. We pray that indeed the prophetic message shall be evident through Uganda Christian University, through the chaplaincy ministry, through the ministers here, that indeed faith will be exercised in this great institution, that true servants will be nurtured and we shall serve diligently. Father, we pray that teachers shall be released who will instruct your children in ways of righteousness. Lord, we pray that you baptize us with love, loving one another, caring for one another, being generous, helping those in need, supporting those in need. Father, we pray that your spirit will be evident in Uganda Christian University. Not only main campus, but all the other campuses. We pray, dear Lord, that your spirit will be evident and will stir all the gifts that are hidden within us. And right now, my sisters and brothers, as we continue to pray, let us pray for the leadership. Yes, the guild president and the team, the guild leadership, and then the leadership of our institution here. Let us pray that God himself will be the leader and that the leaders will guide this institution towards God's plan and vision. Let us pray that we shall submit as well to authority, that we shall not simply look for the speck in their eye, yet we have logs, but we shall be in support and encouragement of our leadership team, both in management, among lecturers, different departments, and then with the student body. Let us pray for the leadership. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you because leadership comes from you. You have told us that you have gifted some with the ability to lead, and you expect us as leaders to lead responsibly and seriously. Father, we pray that management, Lord, will guide as he's guided by you, that indeed the head of department will guide as they are guided by you, that all the non-teaching leaders, staff, non-teaching staff, but the leadership will guide the team as guided by you. The student body, that the guild leadership will guide the students as they are led by you. But as well, we pray that the student body And indeed, the staff community will submit to authority, will submit to the governing authorities. For all authority comes from you. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray that you give us the grace to submit. We pray that you give us the grace to support. We pray that you give us the grace to use our gifts to make this institution the best place that you want it to be. Father, we want to say thank you. We deal with every spirit of rebellion in the name of Jesus Christ. We deal with every spirit of grumbling in the name of Jesus Christ. That complaining spirit, we destroy it in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray, Heavenly Father, for true advice and counsel to our leadership teams, oh God, in the different departments, yes, in the different managerial roles. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you surround them with the right advisors. Above all, that the Holy Spirit will be the true advisor to every leader. Holy Spirit, we surrender this institution. We surrender our leaders to you in all the different facets, departments, sectors, yes, in this great institution. We pray that above all, you will still be on the throne. Forgive us where we have displaced you. Forgive us when the leaders have not consulted you. We learn throughout David's leadership in the Bible. Very often he came to you for advice. Very often he came to you for consultation. We pray that our leaders will constantly consult you. That our leaders will keep in step with you. That our leaders will hearken to the inclination and the leadership of the Holy Spirit. That our leaders will submit to you in your mercy, O God. Take over in our leaders' lives. We thank you. My dear friends, let's take this time to surrender that personal need that you have to the Lord. It may be a need for tuition. It may be a need for academic excellence. It may be a need for a financial breakthrough, marital issue, business issue. Pray to the Lord. He says in his word, ask and you shall receive. Knock and the door shall be opened. Seek and you will find. So now mention. The Bible says in John 16, you have not because you have not yet asked. Ask in my name and it shall be given. So now let us pray. Present those needs to the Lord. In addition to your personal needs, go ahead and mention the general needs. It may be in your hall of residence, and you know there is a gap somewhere. It may be in your department. It may be in your office. It may be in that responsibility that God has given you. There are some needs that are so obvious, and you feel like they are a thorn in the flesh. Just surrender them to the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Asobola, Yesu, asobola. Asobola, Yesu, asobola. Katonda bwabali n'omubiri. Tewali kimulema, asobola. Asobola, Yesu, asobola. Asobola, Yesu, asobola.
Nothing is impossible with God. That's what the song means. Nothing is impossible with God. But he still wants to work through you. He wants you to surrender yourself to him that he may work through you. That's what the song means. Our God is able. He can do everything. And through you, he can do mighty things. Through us. Yes. Let's sing it again.
Asobola, Yesu asobola. Asobola, Yesu asobola.
Yes, Lord.
Katonda wababali no mubiri. Tewali chimulema asobola. 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 Asobola, Yesu asobola. Katonda wababali no
Father, we thank you because nothing is impossible with you. What seems to be impossible in the eyes of men is extremely, very, very possible with you. Yes, absolutely possible. So, Father, we pray that in our midst here, you will purge every fear out of us, that you will purge every anxiety out of us. That you will please purge every worry and panic out of us. But you will fill each and every one of us with faith and confidence in the fact that you are more than able to do exceedingly, abundantly, much more than we can think or imagine. So this evening we give ourselves to you that you may work in and through us. Lord, you want to reveal yourself in this institution. But here we are willing vessels. Please reveal yourself even through us to the glory of your name. Father, we pray that you meet your children at their very point of need. Meet us, O God, because nothing is impossible with you. Father, for all the needs of Uganda Christian University, this main campus and all the different campuses, Lord, we cry to you that you come through. Especially, Lord, we pray that you will send to Uganda Christian University many, many, many students, that they will be mentored in your ways, O God. Father, send to your institution, Uganda Christian University, many students, O God, that they will get value addition to their education. That as they pursue whatever course, Lord, they will have a great value added to them. And that's the most important. That is you. So we pray that you draw many, you will convict many parents, many, many institutions to act as well, many schools to advise their children to choose Uganda Christian University, because your presence is right here. Because at Uganda Christian University, you do not only give degrees, but you also give your presence. You do not only give qualifications, but you also give a distinction. You do not only give excellence, but you give excellence, O God, with character and integrity. So we pray that all our students who are present here, indeed they will excel for the glory of your name. And all that you will send to us and you will ever send to us, we pray, Heavenly Father, that they will leave university as men and women, ordained to be men and women after your own heart. So we thank you. We surrender this institution. We surrender every department. We surrender ourselves. We surrender our students. Those who are not yet back, we give them to you. As the parents are still looking for tuition, Father, provide the tuition. We cry to you because nothing is impossible with you. We give you praise and glory. Into your hands, we dedicate this semester. Into your hands, we dedicate every learning and service and ministry that is going to take place throughout this semester. We dedicate to you and we pray, let your will, as it is in heaven, be so in your great university, to the glory of your name. In Jesus' name we have prayed, and everyone says, hallelujah! Amen. Amen. Shall we join in the words of the grace? May the grace and the love of God, fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen. Dear friends, may our good Father turn his face towards all of us. May his bright light shine so brightly upon us. And may his peace, which transcends human understanding, keep each one of us in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. May his peace guard our hearts jealously in him. And may his blessings be evident upon you because you came. May his blessings be evident upon everyone and everything that concerns you. Blessings of God go before you and after you. The blessings of God be upon this great institution. The blessings of God be upon us throughout this semester, throughout the many activities, the teaching, the learning, the ministry that is going to take place throughout this semester. The blessings of God overtake us and come after us in the name of God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. Come here, my goodness. Are you clapping to me or to God? Hallelujah! Amen. Thank you so much for coming. Just one announcement as before that, then the choir will come in. Just to remind us, only on one, the Men of Purpose Mentorship Program is on. Men of Purpose Mentorship Program is on. So ladies and gentlemen are invited. It will take place on the 28th of May. 28th of May, 2022. And do you know the topic? The topic is hot and interesting. And the topic is about choosing the best Mr. or Mrs. Right. So do you want to come? Yes, please come and be a part of this discussion. It will take place in Principal's Hall from 3 to 5 p.m. Turn to your neighbor and say, do you want to have the best Mr. Right or Mrs. Right? Yes, please, you are invited. Praise the Lord. Please stand up on our feet and let the choir lead us in that one song as we depart. Yes, community worship started on Tuesday, and these 2 days, Tuesday and today, we've been praying and dedicating the semester into the hands of God. But please keep coming again. Let's go deeper in the Lord together. Hallelujah. Turn to your neighbor and thank your neighbor for being your neighbor throughout the time of prayer. Tell them that you'll be glad to see them throughout the semester in that same seat. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, Lord, I want to be among the number. Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in. Oh Lord, I want to be among the number. Oh, when the saints go marching in. When the saints, oh, when the saints, oh, when the saints go marching in. Oh, when the saints go marching in. Oh Lord, I want to be among the number. Oh, when the saints go marching in.